Excuse me. I'd like to call our meeting to order, please. I'll call a meeting of October 22nd, 2013, work session to order at 2:05. Any more, Counselor?
Yes, thank you.
I would like to add one, if we could, a discussion about our procedure, how our procedure works as far as taking things through the chain of command, through departments to Ken.
From our board to any board, our appointed board to any board.
Any board.
Any board.
Just discussion about it.
And how it travels to the county attorney?
Yes.
From any board, county attorney. Motion, second. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries 5-0. Thank you. Seeing the discussion about proper etiquette, proper way to.
Yeah, I'm having trouble getting my hands around this. I guess I just need clarification. In my thinking, if, and I'll just use the planning commission because that's the easiest one to come up with. If, but it could be anything. It could be a parking rec board. It could be any board that's appointed, any advisory board. In my thinking, if they have a policy or a change to an ordinance or something new that they want to see done, it should come to our board first to see if our board has any interest in doing it. Before, right now, they're going directly to Tom, that's going directly to Ken Jarrard. And Ken's drafting something and bringing it to us for a vote.
Excuse me, so you mean, not as an agenda item, one of us should put it on the agenda? Is that what you're saying?
I think there is right now a communication gap between us knowing what the planning commission's doing and what's being done. And they're sending work to Ken to do. Ken's drafting it, and he's bringing it to us then. And I think before Ken goes to the expense of the citizens to draft, we need to say, yeah, we're on board with it or not.
Can I offer just...
Because what if you're going to kill it? What was the waste of money?
Why don't we spend that money?
I agree.
Let me just offer up, because I anticipated this coming, and that's fine.
Thank you for that.
This may be a product of a couple things, but I know the most immediate thing was an action taken by the PC at the last work session. So let me just offer this, not in their defense, but just to make sure that I'm as clear as I can be. The Planning Commission does have, under the UDC, one of their responsibilities is to recommend UDC changes. To recommend. At the last Planning Commission work session, one of the commissioners put on the agenda the notion of basically further information as part of an application as to the identity of members of LLCs and corporations. Okay? The Planning Commission heard the presentation. And the Planning Commission made a motion to direct me and Tom to work with that Planning Commission member to come up with revisions to Chapter 8 of the UDC to incorporate that. Now, where will it go from there? It'll go just like you all do. When sometimes you tell me to go draft an ordinance, I'll bring it back to you to have one more look-see for you. It's going to come back to the PC. The PC then will decide whether they want to then recommend that it come up to you. So to Commissioner Mills' point, she is right, the PC has ordered sort of a product, if you will, as far as a revised Article 8, but it's not coming to you yet. It does have to go back to them at a subsequent meeting for them to ratify whether they want to then send it to you.
And I want to make myself clear. I'm not saying I am for or against what you're talking about.
Absolutely. Yes,
I haven't even seen it. My problem is we're allowing, we've gotten a breakdown in the chain of command, I feel like. I feel like that there are times that people need to be talking to Doug about things instead of going directly to the attorney. Or people need to be talking to the commission about things before. I think it's way too free that everybody feels go to the attorney and get the attorney to fix it. Well, the attorney charges. No offense, but you charge. That's your job. That's what you should do. And if we're never going to get to wanting that policy to be adopted, then it seems like to me that it should at least be discussed by our board before it gets to you.
Are you suggesting, is there anything in general that the public just doesn't have free access to the county attorney and run up a big bill?
Well, I mean.
But unless you suggest that any recommendation.
I don't totally disagree.
Any recommendation.
I'm not aware that we have a surprise bill of any kind from the county.
Well, but he will when he gets done it, but they went to the attorney. But don't you think it should come from planning and zoning board at any appointed board up to here first for us to talk about it? I mean.
It was go to your commissioner and let him bring it forward.
At least talk.
I think it's worth pointing out, we directed the county attorney earlier today to draft a resolution and bring back to us to object to annexation from Alpharetta. Now, if the, whatever there is working on gets done before that, I got a problem with that. Because this is a big deal.
See, that's what bothers me.
So where does it fall into in priority wise?
I thought we made that time sensitive.
We did.
It is time sensitive for him to do it.
But we are talking about, and this is the point I brought up to Tom and to Doug, was when does it reach a point, like I've been wanting to get zoning classifications added residentially. I want to give some flavor so we don't have just lines and houses that are like Kurt's 12-foot long. I want to give so we have some variety in our zoning classifications. And to be honest, ever since Teresa left, there hasn't been time for anybody to do that because they're swamped. And I've understood that. You've wanted to get density put on maps. And we agreed that.
I'm still waiting for an overlay.
And you agreed that you would be happy to wait. But and then I'm sitting here and I'm getting an email. Nobody talked to me on Planning Commission. I get an email from a Rich Franck, who sent it to all of y'all, that's telling me what the Planning Commission is doing and that they've got Ken working on this draft change to the UDC Section 8. And you've been sitting here waiting. I've been sitting here waiting. We've been waiting on impact fees or we've been waiting on this. And I'm thinking, why in the world do they have more persuasion to get things done than we do and we're elected?
Well, I don't know that they do.
Well, they get it done.
Wait a minute.
I'm not aware that anything about the overlay has anything at this point to do with Ken. I'm not aware that the rest three has anything to do with Ken.
But Tom's
from my point of view,
Tom does have something to do with it.
And he swamped.
All I heard was this example was regarding Ken.
I haven't heard a word about Tom yet.
Yeah, it's Tom. Tom took it, I guess, on to take it to you.
They were at the meeting.
Yeah, there was not a whole lot of reflection. It was done at the meeting.
If they give you 20 things to do, and we give you one, what gets done first?
Depends on what they are.
I'm just asking.
No, I mean,
who decides what gets done? I'm just not trying to be smart with you. I mean, do you say, okay, I get the BOC stuff done first, or do you say they ask me first, or do you say I got to decide which one's most important?
I will prioritize based upon having done this a while, which one is most important.
But do you think they should be making policy? If they want to make policy, send it to us to look at before we send.
We've got a breakdown in communication.
Before it's sent to Tom and the council.
We should know about it. I mean, it should come to us. We shouldn't hear about it from a
Why don't they bring it to their own commissioner to bring it up here?
That's right. We put it on the agenda.
Your point is you should bring it up to you for this list of things we've got to take care of on the agenda.
They should bring it to us first. It's an outline.
And then if we want to do it, then we direct Ken to do it. They shouldn't direct
Ken. We still got a bundle anyway.
How did we get the set in policy?
How did we get one?
What we're talking about. In other words, your planning commissioner, your appointee, needs to come to you as their commissioner, bring their idea forward. If it has some validity, then you bring it forward to get an agenda with find your second, like we do, and get it on.
Let
this.
It be a part of a process.
Because you believe in it that much.
What about if you took your park and rec board or your other boards, if they all started doing the same thing? You got a mess.
Zoning Board of Appeals.
You got a mess. I mean, you have no.
If everybody's
changing. There's no hierarchy. There's no process.
If everybody's
there's
changing.
No prioritization.
Exactly. That's what
I'm
looking
for. And
that's
what we need because, I mean, we talked about today $31 million for some road projects. Does this idea get ahead of that? Well, we've got people screaming because they're sitting in traffic.
Do you remember that 9 months ago we threw a lot of things at Tom and he made us do a priority? Well, he had us because he couldn't keep up with it all and we had to vote what was priority?
How we fix it?
If your issue is right now, if the issue right now is the Planning Commission and that seems to be an issue you want to address.
Any appointed board.
Any appointed board.
Well,
But we have draft plans on it right now.
Right, I think the way, way you could do it would be, there's levels, right? There's incremental how you approach things. And the first issue could be, or the first way you resolve would be a letter drafted by the chairman on behalf of the board saying, you know, dear Madam Chairman, in the future, we would like any initiatives like that to at least be at a minimum vetted by the district commissioner or whatever before they actually manifest themselves in instructions.
Before you put them on our list.
Right. If that doesn't get it done, then you increase the next, you see what I'm saying? And then you can go up to the next level. The next level could be a board resolution. The next level could be a UDC modification to start stripping powers.
Yeah.
But so the first step would be a letter from the chairman.
You don't say send a letter? Send a terse letter?
Oh, no, it'd be clear.
This is the first, it'd be friendly.
But it needs to be made clear. There doesn't need to be any leeway of misunderstanding. It needs to be clear.
Well, what are you going to do?
And the point is, and I just make sure I understand, because I'll probably be drafting this for the chairman or helping the chairman draft it. The point is going to be, not that they can't make recommendations, the point is going to be before they begin issuing instructions.
It has to come through your commissioner that appointed you.
Yeah.
Let that be their monkey on their back.
If Tom's got a question, he goes to Doug. If Doug has a question, he comes to us, or Tom can... or let your representative contact you. If Jody wants to have something added or thinks it's worthwhile, go to Jim. Jim brings it to us.
Absolutely.
Same thing for Alan or
any of us. That's right.
Because the planning commission can make a recommendation by my motion and vote, and that doesn't involve any instruction to anybody. If you see what I'm saying?
100%.
Okay. I understand.
Okay. Counselor, you got your orders, please, sir?
I do.
Do we need a motion? Or just?
I think if you could just a motion to prepare and deliver the letter as discussed.
Salute.
Yeah, second.
Have a motion second. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed?
I was going second.
5-0.